see it. And we're going to be doing our predictions for the game week, the opening week fixtures, going through each game. Now, I think I'll probably do this for all of the game weeks. And I'm using the official UEFA one. It's pretty good because it allows me then, when we do our predictions, we can just look back quickly at our previous ones. But yeah, let me get into it then. Of course, let me know your predictions for the games below. And let's begin. So, starting off with Young Boys vs RB Leipzig. Now, straight off the bat, you would expect Leipzig to win this. However, Young Boys, they're no mugs. They do have some sort of Champions League pedigree. They are one of those clubs who are always in the Champions League and always do throw up a couple upsets here and there. If we have a look at their recent form, pretty good. As you would expect, they beat Maccabi Haifa, who I'm pretty sure last year were in PSG's group and did alright. So they're not like a trash side, Young Boys. As for Leipzig, well, they've started the Bundesliga really, really well. Besides that Leverkusen loss, which there's no shame in that, they've done really well. So it'll be tough for Leipzig, but I think they will get it done. I'm going to go for a 2-1 to RB Leipzig on this one. Right, AC Milan versus Newcastle. This is a game which I think is maybe probably the second biggest game of the game week. A little bit disappointed is that 5:45 over early kickoff. Felt like it would have been amazing after an 8 o'clock kickoff, but hey ho. Anyway, AC Milan, Newcastle is a monstrous tie. Newcastle, their first game back in the Champions League for some time, and it's away from home at the San Siro against AC Milan. So you can't really get chucked more into the fire end than this for Newcastle. If you have a look at the forms of the teams, Milan have started the season on fire. I must say, I'm filming this also before. I filmed this on the Saturday, so they are going to play other games like Milan are playing Inter. They might lose that, which could affect them, and it could be injuries and stuff that also affect these teams. But Milan have started the season off well. They're looking good. Leao, Pulisic, Reinders, these guys look fantastic. Newcastle, on the other hand, have not started the season off very well at all. They've lost their last three games. I do see Milan winning this. I see them winning it. I don't think there'll be many goals in it, though. I think Newcastle are going to go there, sit back, try and soak up as much pressure as they can. But I do feel like maybe it might be a little bit too much for them as they're going away to the San Siro. For a lot of these players, have never really featured in European competition. That's a bit of an ask. So I'm going to go for 2-0 AC Milan. Shakhtar Donetsk vs Porto. Let's have a look at the forms. Shakhtar, strong start to the season, as you would expect. They are by far and away the best team in Ukraine. Porto have started the season off pretty well, similar fashion. I believe this is going to be in Poland, right, like last year. So it's kind of home advantage, but not really for Shakhtar. I don't know, this is a game I could see Porto slipping up on. I'm actually going to go for a draw. I'm going to go 1-1. I think Shakhtar could be able to get someone against Porto. Barcelona, Antwerp. Well, I mean, you would expect Barcelona to cruise by. Let's have a look at Antwerp. Okay, so Antwerp, maybe EK Athens to get here. And QSG. Yeah, the start is in off pretty well. I can't lie, I don't know too much about Antwerp. But if Barcelona don't win this at home, serious questions need to be asked. I mean, I don't think it'll because just knowing Barcelona in the Champions League recently, they have been shocking. Even last year, with Xavi in charge, not the best. So I think I'll get like a 2-0 victory. I don't think it'll be the most convincing victory, but they should get that job done. Man City vs. Krefena. I honestly have no clue how you say this. This is Red Star Belgrade though, right? It's Red Star Belgrade, I'm pretty sure. We'll just call them Red Star. So Red Star vs. Man City, I mean, it doesn't really matter what Red Star's form is, they're gonna get absolutely battered on them. If Man City field their best 11, they're at home as well. If it was away from home, they might have a little bit of a chance, but away from home, then they have no chance. I'm going for a 4-0 Man City. PSG Dortmund, now this is another game which is really, really tasty. PSG have suffered really recently. Not started the season off well, just lost at home to Nice 3-2, which is a devastating loss. Although Dylan Mbappe has started the season off really well, he got a brace there. But Dortmund as well have started the season off really poorly, so two teams have started the season off poor. Promises for an interesting tie in a close game. I think this is going to be tough. You know what, I think it should be a draw, I think it'll be a 1-1. I just think both teams are not in their best shape right now. Both teams are going to try and make sure they don't lose this game, and I think it'll be a close game, and it'll probably end a draw in 1-1. Lazio, Atletico Madrid. Interesting game, Lazio, first game back in the Champions League for a couple seasons now. First game under Maurizio Sarri. Lazio have started the season off not the best, but picked up with a fantastic win over Napoli, 2-1 win, and they're playing Juve, so by the time you see this, they might have won that. Lazio do actually do quite well against those bigger sides, to be fair to them. Last year they did pull off quite a few upsets. Atletico have started the season off insane, 7-0 versus Real Vallecano, 0-0 versus Betis, but 3-1 versus Granada. And Atletico Madrid have suddenly, you know, since January, have been one of the most exciting teams to watch, which is interesting. Now, I don't know if Simeone is going to, in the Champions League, refer back to the type and play boring defensive football. But they are away from home. It's going to be a tough game, I think, for both of these teams. And to be honest, I see it ending a draw as well. I think it'll be, you know, I think it'll be a 2-2. Be a good game, and I think it'll be a close one. I think these two teams are very well set up, and I think it'll end a draw. Feyenoord versus Celtic. Feyenoord have, well, they have started the season off right where they left off, 5-1 win, 6-1 win. Last year they were fantastic in terms of goals, and they're doing that again. Celtic beat Rangers 1-0. Big result for them. Is that Feyenoord? I would suspect Feyenoord are going to win this. Celtic under Brendan Rodgers, who, I mean, he has some European experience, I guess, but Feyenoord are such a well-drilled side under Arne Slot. I think they're gonna get a really nice victory here, 3-1. 3-1 for Feyenoord. Right, Real Madrid, Union Berlin. This is a really fun game because this is Union Berlin's first game in the Champions League ever, and it's, I said Newcastle got chucked in the fire, and these guys are going to Real Madrid and playing at the Bernabeu in their first ever Champions League game. You can't get more, like, there's literally not a fixture in the world that is more Champions League than this. Like, they are getting chucked in the deep end. The question is, will they drown? How will they do at the Bernabeu? Are they going to pull off a shock? Well, Real Madrid have started the season off fantastic. Jude Bellingham has been amazing. Union Berlin have a bit of a mixed bag. Obviously lost 3-0 to Leipzig, which was an ideal, but they had 10 men. You know, I don't think they're going to get seen them frustrating Madrid for quite a while. Madrid haven't really been blowing teams away as well. You know, they've been very close games. You know what? For the story, Berlin snatched a draw at the Bernabeu in their first ever Champions League game. Was imagine if they won it. Wow, that would be insane. But I think the most they'll get is a draw, to be honest. Galatasaray, Copenhagen. Okay, let's have a look. So Galatasaray have started season off well. Beat Molde to get in. Copenhagen beat Rakow to get in. Started season off well. Galatasaray though at home. I think their home is going to be an absolute fortress. That place is going to be rocking. I think they're going to be up for this, and I think that home front is going to get them the victory. I think they'll get a 2-0. Benfica versus RB Salzburg. So Benfica starts it off pretty well. Salzburg, fantastic start of the season, as you would expect. Again, no Benfica at home. You have to kind of back them here. It's going to be a difficult ask for Salzburg to get something from here. I think it'll end 2-1 to Benfica. Sociedad versus Inter Milan. Sociedad's first game in Champions League since, I think, a decade. Inter Milan have started to see not fantastically, though, won all their games so far. Sociedad, not the greatest start, but they're going to be up for this. Their home fans are going to be up for it at home. But Inter are just a fantastic side in the Champions League. As we saw last year, I think they'll get the victory. I think they'll be a 2-1 victory for Inter. Braga vs Napoli, similar style to Sociedad. Braga at home, first time back in the Champions League for a couple seasons now. Up against Napoli, they've started to off well. Napoli lost to Lazio, but besides that, they've started off pretty well. You know what, I think Braga can actually get something here. I think they could get something at home. I'm going to back them to get a victory. Arsenal, PSV, how have PSV done this season? Okay, they started the season pretty well, smacked up Rangers to get here. But I think Arsenal at home, first game back in the Champions League for a long time. They're going to be up for this. They obviously beat PSV last season at home. So I suspect they'll do it again. I think it'll be a pretty easy one. I think it'll be a 3-1 victory for Arsenal. Sevilla vs Lons. Sevilla have started the season really poorly. I'm pretty sure they're like bottom of La Liga, which is shocking. Yeah, they haven't even won a game this season. Lons though have started the season off shocking as well. Although they have had some tough games. So two teams who really need victories. Sevilla at home. Lons haven't been in the Champions League for a long time. So I don't know, both teams are struggling here, both teams could feel they could snatch a win. I think for that reason, and the draw, I think it'd be a boring 0-0. Alright, and finally the game of the game week for me, Bayern Munich vs Man United. It's Bayern Munich starters in, not fantastically, a bit shaky. Snatch a win vs Gladbach and then drew to Leverkusen, to be honest. I thought that would have worse side in that game and could have lost that. But United as well haven't started the season off great. Lost to Tottenham and Arsenal. It's going to be tough. But I think Man United, to be honest, their away record against the big sides is horrific, as we all know. They don't win away from home against the big sides. So, to be honest, I see them getting smacked up here. Harry Kane, he loves scoring against Man United. At Bayern Munich at home, two guys a good record in the Champions League. I actually think it would be a really easy 3-0 for Bayern. I could see them just destroying them. And we'll play the 2x booster. Right, those are the predictions for the game week. Let me know if you agree or disagree with those predictions. And if you have enjoyed, please leave a like, consider subscribing. I'll see you in another video.